But then there are leaders in your party who have behaved with women in the most disgraceful manner. Can you comment on that, please? And they happen to be from your very state.
I totally object.
Has the Congress party disassociated itself from such leaders after court verdicts? No. Has the Congress party taken any disciplinary action against such leaders? No. That only shows how serious the Congress party is about women and their respect.
Which is defenseless. And you must ask Mr. Modi to apologize. You cannot shout and, you know, drown the very basic mistake. I think your entire leadership, Congress entire leadership has to apologize to the nation
for many of its blunders. And for 100 days, you promised you will bring down the inflation after coming to power.
Let's assume.
1500 days and nothing has been done. And there are larger issues.
There are manner.
Rahul,
may I come in, please? I come on a point.
What kind of words which Modi?
May I please make a simple point to Mr. Rao and Mr. Narvekar? I know that I'm a spring chicken, but I'm not so much of a novice that I don't understand the way in which points are to be made. As a political reporter, I've had the opportunity to see some speeches. Look, I want to ask Vinod Mehta tonight, our senior in the profession. You know, we have seen state elections, Mr. Mehta, chest thumping happens. Rhetoric happens. Yeah. But is it going a little out of whack of late?
I think that's putting it very mildly. I think this is, you know, no one objects to a discussion on corruption. I mean, you want to attack somebody for corruption, you attack somebody for corruption. But you want to attack somebody for double standards, you attack somebody for double standards. But I find this completely bizarre that someone who is going to be the prime ministerial candidate of the BJP should resort to such vulgarity and coarseness. I mean, it's just the bad taste. You are saying that woman is worth 50 crores of rupees. I'm sure if you want to say Shashi Tharoor is corrupt, there are other ways of saying Shashi Tharoor is corrupt. Or directly say Shashi Tharoor is a corrupt minister. Why did Mr. Manmohan Singh induct him? Why do you have to make this tamasha of his wife? And Mr. Modi has always had difficulty with his tongue. He is not a man who likes to watch what he's saying. Now he gets carried away at election meetings at Himachal Pradesh, because I think both the sides have corruption charges against them, so they want to raise these extraneous issues. But I am shocked, and I would that Mr. Modi has, by even his low standards, he has outdone himself. I mean, this is terrible. And whatever other Congress chief ministers of UP may have done, that's not the issue. That's also condemnable. How does that justify what Mr. Modi is doing? How does that justify that Mr. Modi, who is going to be or who is allegedly the candidate for the prime minister of this country? Do you want a prime minister of this country, presumably when he becomes prime minister, to use this kind of language? I mean, it's shameful that we are even discussing this thing and saying that this is condemnable. Of course, this is condemnable.
So,
and if you look behind it, or you look besides it, or you look under it, there is no justification. This is if you look at this statement,
why are we
bold statement? It is shameful.
So why are we debating this today? Because principally for a point, I don't want to obsess about what he said about Sunanda Pushkar. I don't think that is of much import. But I am saying tonight that you cannot take away form from content. If my point tonight, please hear me clearly, Mr. Rao. I'm saying tonight you cannot take form away from content. Your content is that you want to target the Congress on the issue of corruption. But the manner in which you do it is of as much relevance, and it is expected of national leaders that their form will justify their content. Am I wrong in making that basic expectation, Mr. Rao?
No, I think you have to give it to him. Mr. Modi has been the chief minister of Gujarat for 11 years. He is sure, by far, all the polls suggest he is winning a much bigger term. And he is extremely popular with both men and women in Gujarat. And some of his actions and some of his policies concerning the welfare of women and girl child They show the sensitivity of the human being towards the requirements towards the gender. And it's very funny to expect to just look at one statement with a microscope and misinterpret when he says.
No, I am not
crores,
only I am not only on this issue.
That is
I am asking
that
you
is
tonight.
The amount that was being discussed,
sir, no,
in
sir,
the media,
am, sir,
and that is the kind of a benefit that Ms. Pushkar. Let me complete. Ms. Pushkar has got mainly because she is friendly with Mr. Shashi Tharoor. There is no other way why
she got
that money.
Let me tell you one thing. As far as this whole IPL issue was concerned, you are more than aware that, you know, Times Now was very, very critical, raised a few critical points, and I think that we were quite, you know, straightforward in our questions to Shashi Tharoor. That's not the question tonight. My question tonight is the quality of discourse. The question Kamal Farooqi, and I go back to him, raises that today, where do our national leaders, when you go to a state, what is the relevance of Sunanda Pushkar to a Himachal Pradesh election? And how do you make it? Where are the informed debates? Who is enunciating the vision for this country, the path for development? Why does Modi not speak about development? Since he says my focus is on development. Why does it have to become such a negative campaign? This question goes to the Congress
that's
the point I'm trying to make. Instead of going behind the words of Mr. Narendra Modi,
I'm saying
let's debate the point he's making, the double standards of the Congress party.
The point is
the Congress party has no issue against Mr. Narendra Modi, at least in Gujarat, other than playing that communal card, which too I think bears no ground, for the simple reason this is a man who has been given the mandate by the people more than once on two occasions. He is a man who's been given a clean sheet by the SIT. He's the person against whom charges, cases have been remanded by the Apex Court. The Congress has only one card against
him, and
that is the communal card, which will hold no good.
Kamal Farooqi,
please bring all those kind of things. The nation knows. Nation knows what Modi ji has been doing.
And what constitutes the nation? What constitutes the nation? Does it constitute the electorate of Gujarat, or does it constitute Mr. Farooqi?
The quality of the discussion and the debate should be on the basis of the Indian culture. We should have a dignified debate on all these issues. Let us not try to go off the track.
Is there attempt at provocation? Let's address it deeply.
Well, Mr. Arnab, Mr. Narasimha said that the Chief Minister is very concerned about the women and children in Gujarat. Now, the worst cases of anemia, the maximum number of women with anemia are in Gujarat.
No, let's not.
The most unnourished children are in Gujarat. Okay.
No, this but that's not. Let's not divert.
This is the debate that should be talked about.
Let's have a different debate.
Political
on development
victory,
in Gujarat. The
political
whole world has accepted
it. Is a different
it.
Thing. You can't
and
become
Gujarat
individual.
Is,
you can't
him
become individual. Yes.
For let him better
can't become individual in your attack.
No, but is there an attempt?
You can't go public. You can't go on, targeting persons, people, and undermining their dignity in such bad tenor in which Mr. Modi spoke today. Did you see his body language? Did you see the way he was talking with his hands flinging around? He was making mockery of the lady, and he was trying to say that there are women who can be got for lesser price. She is the most expensive.
No.
What do you mean? What does he want to say?
That is absolutely. I think. She has undermined
the dignity of women.
And his comments are being completely twisted out of context.
He is extremely careful. He is
extremely respectful towards women.
No, no. What's
that? The people of the country know.
You ask him to apologize.
Whatever Congress party might try to. They might try to attack him on this.
The country is watching.
And absolutely, it will have no conviction.
Why doesn't the television go to the women in the streets and ask them whether they approve of this statement or not? 100 out of 100 women will say that Modi ji should apologize.
Miss Joshi, may I ask you?
Anyone who knows the context, background, would not make that comment.
Miss Joshi.
Because she was in the thick of that controversy. She was the beneficiary in that particular allegation of corruption against
Mr. Rao.
Mr.
Rao, you have been an observer of the media. It is
you
often said that if you make a good point but in a very bad way, you end up ruining your own case. This is a well-known adage. My question to you tonight is, I go to Vinod Mehta. Vinod Mehta, this is the politics of provocation. Modi is deliberately provoking the Congress and the BJP. will he achieve his political purpose while doing so?
No, but Arnab, he may, I don't know whether he's achieved his political purpose, because the discussion today all over India on his speech is very negative. And I would, this is the one occasion where I think Mr. Modi deserves to, needs to apologize to the women of this country. But I just want to make one other point. If Mr. Narendra Modi is so confident, and if he has all the facts on his side, why does he have to say these things? I mean, why does he have to descend to the gutter to talk about these matters? This, after all, Mr. Gadkari is also corrupt. Tomorrow, somebody from the Congress can make personal remarks about somebody in Gadkari's family and say that, well, we are only showing the corruption in Gadkari's family. So what is this justification that you make personal remarks about his wife, about how much she is available for, what is her sale price, and say that you are trying to highlight corruption? If the BJP get it back on for their own people, how would they like it?